Hey everybody, it's your girl Plenty Ty on deck. I hope you guys are having a great day, afternoon, and or evening whenever you guys are seeing this. So thank you guys so much for tuning in with your girl. As you guys see, I'm over here minding my black business. Yeah, I got my superhero on deck, bestie.
Sam, I am the superhero.
So we on deck. But anyways, if you guys want to hear all about how my coworker set the damn break room on fire, all y'all got to do, stay tuned. All right, you guys, so I'm back on deck. Thank you guys so much for tuning back in with your girl. Y'all already know I appreciate that, right? Okay, so before I get into this story time, let me go ahead and send a shout out and a great big cyber hug to my sis, Emma from Montgomery Family Vlogs. Y'all know I talk too fast and then talk over my words, but Emma sent me sister friend mail. If you guys see my address, it's not a, let me cover hers, but if y'all see mine, it's not a big deal. It's just a P.O. box or whatever. But she sent this, and I tore this part open. I didn't open it all the way, so let me open this right quick while I'm on camera, then I'm going to jump into this story time. Now, already I'm in love with whatever this is, Emma, because it is red, and if you guys can't tell, red is one of my favorite colors right next to purple. I love red. I love purple. Light up the comments and let me know what is some of y'all favorite colors at home. You know, I'm thinking about, like, for this spring, this summer, I like color. Well, see, I can't really get it. I can get away with it, but sometimes if it's only certain ways, like colors like yellow, I do like stuff like that, you know? So I like to be colorful. It's in my nature. So anyways, I might be doing some of that this summer. So is this this is an apron? Yeah, this is an apron. Okay, hold on. Let me try this apron on. Well, y'all might not be able to see. Let me see if I can get my bestie to hold a camera and take a picture. I'll try to get her to hold a camera and take a picture. Y'all can see. Now, I haven't been doing a whole bunch of cooking lately. But this is really cute, Emma. Thank you. And it's a favorite color of mine. But when I do get up in the kitchen and start handling my business, baby girl, your girl Planet Ty, okay? Of course, I will most definitely be pulling out this beautiful apron. Y'all can't really see it. Hold on. Let me step out the car. Hold on, y'all. Okay, as you can see, I'm outside, but I had to put this on for you one time just so you could see what it looks like. Up under that, of course, I got my this jogging suit on, you know, minding my black-owned business and all of that. But I put this apron on top just so you could see it. Thank you, Emma. I really appreciate it. And when I do get in the kitchen and decide to get down and get to cooking and stuff, your girl's going to reach straight for the red because that's how I get down. So thank you again. Mwah. All right, guys, so if you guys are not already connected with Montgomery Family Vlogs, Emma, you guys go ahead and I'm gonna leave the link in my description so you guys could check her out. She's real cool beans, y'all. Okay, now let's get into this story from many moons ago, okay, about my coworker who set the darn kitchen on fire. Now, let me give you a little background history about my coworker. She was, I don't want to say her name. I never want to say people's name, but I'm just gonna, her name did start with a C, so I'm gonna call her C Lady. Okay, so anyways, me and C Lady, when I was working there, I think before her, and she was originally from, I want to say maybe Germany or something like that. She talked with the accent. I really liked her accent, you know. So me and her, whatever level we connected on, we didn't sit too far from each other. When she first got there, you know how when people's energy matches, just matches, okay? Because at the time we were working for this company called Providian, which is a credit card company. Or whatever else, and we were, you know, doing customer service work. So anyways, when we met, we clicked, we connected, we was laughing about whatever we were laughing about. And C Lady was about maybe 15 years older than me, okay? And I tend to gravitate and like people who are more seasoned, if you guys know what I mean. Because I like people who have more life. I mean, I tend to gravitate towards people who have more life experiences because they're usually not with the bull, if y'all follow me. Anyways, like the comments if you know what I mean. So anyways, so with me and C Lady, we had went out a couple times. You know, we took lunch together. We would be telling each other about each other's family stories. I got a funny family story I heard to tell y'all about. And we even went out and had drinks together, you know, after work a couple times or whatever else. So we was cool. I was with C Lady one time. Well, I'll tell you guys about that story later. I digress. Okay, this particular story. So me and C-Lady, we used to also share lunches, right? You know, just it just depends on who had the money for what at what time. Now, I'm one of those people where whoever I'm with or I'm good with or we cool with or whatever else, if you know what, if it's lunchtime, if you ain't got it, I got you. Don't worry. If I got you, you know what I mean? If we good, I got you. If you don't got it, you know what I mean? And that's usually the way I keep my circle. Now, my bestie, the superhero, she's my ace, because me and her, we are two peas in a pot like that. It's one of those things with us where I could walk in the store with not a dollar to my name, okay, and I will just start putting stuff on the counter or in the basket just as fast as her, because I know bestie, that's, you know, I don't have to question nothing like that, you know. But there's only certain people in life you can move it like that. So if you got somebody like that, then cool beans, hold on to them. Well, me and C-Lady, we was cool like that, you know what I mean? So this particular day, I forgot I had, I don't know what happened on this day. I don't know what happened with the whole lunch. I don't know if I had leftovers, because from something I made the night before or whatever else. But anyway, C-Lady, she was like, it was lunchtime. She met me in there. She came in there like maybe 5 minutes after I was already in the cafeteria. And she was like, Ty, I got this great food that she had got from a restaurant. She was all excited about it, and she said she wanted me to try it. And meanwhile, I'm already sitting at the table because I was waiting on her to come in, and I was like, okay, you want to, where is it at? Do you want to eat this? Because whatever, it said spaghetti the night before, or cornbread or whatever. I was like, you want to eat this while we wait? Or whatever, because my food was already hot. So she sat down and she was like, yeah. So she grabs a fork and she, you know, she was like, oh, hold on. She puts her food that she got from the restaurant in the microwave. Bestie, you remember what I told you? I'm laughing already, you guys, because she puts it in the microwave, right? But then she sits down and she gets a fork and she starts eating out of whatever I had. Me and her talking blah, 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 right? And then all of a sudden, I start smelling smoke, right? And it's like, you know, the mechanical smoke, like a machine is burning smoke. And I look around and I'm like, then I start seeing smoke. I was like, see, lady, oh my God, what's going on? I was like, where's your food? You guys, why see, lady? I love her to pieces. That was crazy for her to do. Why does see? You guys know those tan pants? You guys know those tan pants? Like, you know, bestie, I can't even stop laughing. Oh my God, now get the camera going crazy. Calm down, Ty. Emma, you got me talking to myself like you do. Calm down, Ty. Okay. It's those tin pans that you could put in the oven. They are oven safe. The pans are foil, right, bestie? Aren't they foil pans? Made of foil because they're tin,
like that,
right?
Yeah, they're tin. They're like, the thick, you know.
They're foil pans.
Yeah, but they're basically they're foil. They're basically
I don't know. Maybe I'll look for a picture once so I can insert it so you guys know what I'm talking about, right? That's what her food was in. She put that pan in the microwave. And then she pressed on. She put the microwave on for like 10 minutes, okay? Within a couple minutes in, we start smelling, you know, not even a couple minutes, actually. It was like a few seconds in, we start, you know, smelling smoke. And then I start seeing smoke, and I asked her, see, lady, where's your food? And she was like, oh, I put it in the microwave right there. Do you know that one of the girls, because it was a customer service job, so it was a bunch of young girls, you know, I should say young adults or whatever else, right? And so one of the girls starts screaming, oh my God, it's on fire, right? And then one of the, when she said it's on fire, she ran outside the cafeteria. It was like pretty, it was a pretty big cafeteria, pretty nice. It was like the cafeteria at the time could seat like maybe about 8 to 10 people, about 10 people. About 10 people or something else like that. So it was crowded. It had a lot of chairs in there. It was a few different microwaves, you know, laid out on different counters and stuff. It had a nice refrigerator. I mean, you know, a Keurig, a coffee machine, and a separate coffee machine, you know, and stuff like that. So it was a fairly nice cafeteria. So when she ran out screaming, that one girl, and you know, it's on fire. I was like, what's on fire? I turn around. I see C-Lady running in the direction of the microwave. The microwave that she had put her food in. And then she comes, that's me. I'm sorry, this is too funny for me. I don't know why. But she comes holding the tin foil thing that was completely engulfed in smoke. Whatever in it was burnt, okay? But she she was, it was engulfed in smoke, and she comes, it was still smoking while she was holding it, you guys. It was quite the sight to see. She comes home to be asking me, can this go in the microwave? And I'm saying to myself, see, lady, you gotta be kidding me, right? Okay? You gotta be kidding me, because why didn't you, if you didn't know if the aluminum, if the tin pan could go in the microwave, here's my whole thing. Why you didn't say nothing before? Why did you put it in the microwave and let it start a fire? And then go say, then gonna ask me, gonna pull it out with it still smoking in your hand and bring it to me as if it might have been mine. I was like, oh no. I was like, can this go in? And the guy was like, well, so the supervisor guy, he came in. He was older than us, but well, he was older than me, because remember, C Lady was the oldest. But he was older than the rest of the young adults who was in there, because everybody was in their 20s at the time, right? So, but anyway, he was like, okay, so who started the fire? He came with the fire extinguisher and started putting it out in the microwave. Meanwhile, she's at the table holding it like she's presenting it to me, talking about, can this go in the microwave? I'm looking at her, and I'm like, you should have said that before you put that in the microwave, okay? Not, you know, I was like, you know, that's the question you asked before. I'm no rocket scientist. I don't think you're supposed to put it in and then ask, you know. And I was like, yeah, you're not supposed to put the tin pan in the microwave. She was like, oh, okay, I didn't know. And when he, you know, after he put the fire out, he's looking around the room viciously because he wants blood at this point. He wants to know who the hell started that fire, right? And I was like, you know what? I told her, I said, if I was you, I'd just leave the thing on the table, walk on out of here. You know, you don't need to be written up or nothing else, you know. Not like they could. They couldn't write you up for something like that. Well, actually, technically they could, because it's endangerment and it's destruction of the office property. But she just didn't know any better. She just didn't know any better, y'all. But anyways, y'all light up the comments if you guys have ever experienced a similar like situation that like my coworker. I see, lady, I absolutely loved her, okay? She was funny. She was, that situation, I don't know why it made me laugh. So it probably the look on her face, okay? The look on her face when she took it out of the, it was still smoking, you guys. She takes it out of the microwave and acts like she's presenting it to me, talking about, can this go in the microwave? Girl, the microwave is over there on fire. What do you think? Do you still think realistically it should be in the microwave? I'm a cornball. You guys already know that. It tickled me to no oblivion that, I don't know why, that she just did something like that. But anyways, we end up walking out, and the food that we was eating of mine, you know, we just took it on out. And we like we was taking a walk, and we just end up splitting that, okay, and calling that a day or whatever else, because lunch break was over. But there was a lot of chatter throughout the office, you know, because females chatter, chatter, chatter. You know, all people chatter, chatter, chatter. But I got to say, sometimes us lovely females, I think we do the lion's den with all that chattering, to be honest with you. But people was all in the, you know, in the bathroom, in the break room, you know. It's like if they would see us coming in, or they'll see, you know, her coming, they would be like, oh, you know, just making little comments and stuff like that about, you know, or they'll be talking not to her, but they would be talking like, oh, that was the lady right there, you know. Because people's like, oh, what, people in the hallway? It was a lot of people's different suites and stuff, a big building that we worked at. So people was like, what happened, what happened, you know, everybody wanted to know what happened or whatever. And people was like, oh, that lady, she, you know, she, they didn't even, some people didn't even know her name, but they was like, that lady, she set the microwave on fire. So you guys light up the comments and let me know if you guys have ever experienced something like that. Have you ever been the person who set the microwave on fire, or a similar like crazy experience, like you just never saw it going that way? You guys, I never saw it going that way, or whatever else. I just remember we went outside and she was smoking a cigarette to calm her nerves down, and I just remember we laughed so hard. I was like, girl, I don't know what that was about. I just don't know what got in your head, you know. And she's like, oh, well, I thought you could do it. I said, do you? I said, I was asking her, when you at home? I was like, when you be at home, is that how you warm your food up? And she said, well, no. And I was like, dude, why you do that? Just curious. I cannot,
you guys.
But in all
fairness, if she used the same pan and she was at home.
In the oven.
Me, that's what I was going to say. In all fairness, if she did warm her food up, she would be fine.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
She would be fine,
you know,
if she did, you know.
I cannot, you guys. I just, it tickled me to no oblivion is what I'm suggesting. If you guys are new here, please make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Tell anyone and everyone. Your girl's out here car vlogging and story timing and telling you guys about stuff that happened to me in my life. And I'm just sharing my journey, y'all. I'm just sharing my journey. And I appreciate you guys being on deck for this, okay? So, anyways, if you guys would like to sponsor the story time or any other story time, you guys can do so by dancing on over to Cash App, put in $, your favorite besties. Yes, and that's what it is. Hey, y'all, I'm going to jump off here right now, okay? I got errands to run. I'm minding my black-owned business, like I said before. I just want to tell you guys about my girl, C-Lady. I miss you, C-Lady. I don't know where you are in this world right now. You could be back in Germany. I don't know, but I miss you, girl. And if I ever run into you again, I'm going to give you a big old cyber hug and kiss. No, a big old hug and kiss. Well, maybe cyber because, you know, it's still COVID and all that. But anyways, love you lots. Thank you guys so much for rocking with me. Bestie, you going to say bye?
Bye!
Bestie, crazy. Mm-hmm. Like I always say, there's always another story to be told. But for now,
superhero out!